Hey, math class, this is Mr. Jacobs. Let's take a couple of minutes to look at questions on the quiz that we struggled with. So the first one is question number 10. It's a question about submarines, and so I'm just going to zoom in here, and it says we have two submarines, submarine A and B, with minimum and maximum depths. So the maximum depth for submarine A is negative 542. Max for submarine B is negative 626. And the question is, you're supposed to find the submarine with the largest range. And how do you find the range? Well, up top here it says, to find the range, you take the largest number and subtract from it the smallest number. So we had problems with that. That's what we missed. So when I look at these ranges, there's two of them. Two sets of numbers. Which one is the largest number? Well, let's take a look. The largest number, negative 542, is over here somewhere, right? And negative 287 is over here somewhere. The larger number is 287, right? It's closer to zero, see it? So what you do to find the range of submarine A's, you take the larger number, negative 287, and subtract from it the smaller number, negative 542. So this becomes negative 287 plus 542. Remember the rules of subtraction, add the opposite. And now these are different signs, and so when you subtract these, you end up with this number. 542 plus negative 287.
That would be 255.
And so that's the range for sub A. So the range for submarine B, same situation. So we have two of these values. And let's find out which one is the largest number. So 335 is about right here. And negative 626 is over here. So 335 is larger. Again, that's the definition of range. So this becomes negative 335. Add the opposite. So let's find out what the answer is. Negative 335 plus 626.
It's 291.
So which has the largest range? Submarine B. And when you answer this question, you are asked to find the range of submarine A, the range of submarine B. And so these are the values that you should plug in, 255 and 291. And so which sub has the largest range? This one here. And there's a drop down menu to pick submarine B. Alrighty. So that's one that we struggled with. I have a feeling it was finding the range values. Now number 9 says, find the total change in temperature in 4 hours. Question was a little more descriptive than that, but I'm trying to make this quicker. So to find the total, you always add. Are you following? So all that means is you look at these changes in temperature all the way in the right column and add them up. So you're taking -3 plus -1 plus 2 plus 8 and adding them. So -3 plus -1, that's -4, plus 2 plus 8 is 10. And you subtract these, 10 minus 4 is 6, and that's your answers. Keep the sign of the positive, largest positive number, 10. And so the change in temperature is 6. 6 degrees Fahrenheit. And that's what goes in the box. And the last question that we struggled with was one that maybe you've seen in a previous course, but it's to graph the solution on the number line. So it says D is at most negative absolute value of 5. So I want to share with you what that means. D is at most means means less than. Or equal to. Alrighty, less than or equal to. So when I write this, it would be D is less than or equal to the absolute value of negative 5, which we know is positive 5. And so that is the solution. And the way you plot this on the number line is you take positive 5, which is here. Oops, don't want to do that. Positive 5, which is here. And D is less than or equal to. Move to the left. Now, I have a feeling that you had trouble picking what, you know, which graph to choose on Big Ideas Online, so maybe I'll walk you through that in class, but that's how you graph that, okay? So like I always say, study hard, learn a lot. We'll see you soon. Bye-bye.